I am installing a one-chip ISP screen into my Game Boy Advance today on Arctic Lab Services. I got this kit off of eBay. The bad thing is that it comes from China, so it does take a couple weeks to arrive. But the good thing is that it's cheap and it comes with everything you need except for the Game Boy Advance mainboard. The shell comes in a variety of colors and is pre-cut for the larger screen. If you would like me to show you how to cut your own shell, let me know in the comments below. Be sure to watch this tutorial in full before attempting it. Let's start by putting together the screen assembly. Pull back one edge of the protective film and line it up to one corner and one edge of the screen. Then press it down in a sweeping motion as you peel the backing off. You'll never see this, so it's okay to have a few tiny bubbles. Now line up the Lego style connector to the socket and press it down. Don't force it. If it doesn't click, realign it and try again. Flip the assembly over. I use thin double-sided tape. You can use the center of the screen gasket if you don't have any. Folding the driver board over, line up the two edges before sticking it down. This will help with the alignment of the ribbon cable later. This is the screen gasket. You can use the center part of this on the previous step. Peel off the outer part of the seal. Place it gently around the screen bezel. It's best to start with the corners, then stick down the edges as you line them up. With the gasket installed, remove the backing. Peel off the screen protector and set it aside. Line the screen up to the top right corner, then press it down. I forgot to show it, but I did put the screen protector back on the front of the screen. The small spacer may need to be trimmed. Squeeze the small spacer in along the left edge of the screen. It is a tight fit. Press firmly to make sure it is all the way in. The big spacer needs to be trimmed to allow the touch sensor to fit in the middle. Line up the spacer and mark the center. Then cut out about 6 millimeters out of the center. Take one piece and press it in all the way to the right, just under the screen assembly. Then take the other piece and press it in all the way to the left. These pieces are also a tight fit. Now it's time for the touch sensor. The bottom sensor goes in the middle of the bottom spacer. Remove the adhesive backing and position it in between the two bottom spacers. It can be a bit finicky. Make sure it is not touching the metal frame of the screen. The top sensor goes on the top part of the shell. It should look like this. You can activate the sensors by touching the top part of the shell and just below the screen here. Now it's time to put in all the buttons and membranes, starting with the LED light pipe so you don't forget it. Next, we'll do the mainboard. I find it easier to install the ribbon cable into the mainboard first. The big end of the ribbon cable goes into the mainboard shiny side up. Then put the smaller end into the display driver board. Then flip the mainboard into the shell, lining up the posts with the holes. Put the side rails in. Then screw in these three screws. Put the back cover on, lining up the battery terminals. Then screw in these seven screws. Note that the bottom center one is different. Put the battery cover on, then flip it over. Time to install the custom lens. Peel off everything on the back lens, including the center paper. Peel off the screen protector. Use it to get any dust that may have gotten in. Line up the top edge and one corner to make sure it's lined up before pressing it down. Then remove the screen protector from the new lens. Let's put in some batteries and a game to test it out. Count 8 different color palettes and 10 brightness levels. Considering that this kit includes everything, this is a really good deal and easy to install. I don't have any other modded Game Boy Advances, but this looks really good. But that's my opinion. Thanks for watching.